Hey guys, it's Beth here, and today I've got another gameplay and first impressions video for you. Today it'll be the game Nero, which came out on the 15th of May. The game's developed and published by Storm in a Teacup, and is available on the Xbox Live Store for the price of $15.99. Now, Nero is a puzzle adventure type game, so let's see what the game has to offer.
Out beyond ideas of wrongness and rightness, there is a field. I will meet you there, my beautiful.
So this is basically a story about a boy who is basically dying, and it's just showing the struggle to save him. Now, I don't think the game has any combat. It is just puzzles, as you'll see further on in the game.
A simple smile can easily hide the saddest eyes.
So the first thing you see is basically they are telling the story in the form of having, I guess, the words up in the air. So you've just entered the world and you're learning the start of the story from what's written up there.
And a thousand smiles can blind anyone from seeing the sorrow inside. If given a chance, painful truths will always be conquered by denial.
The environment's very nice in the game. So at the moment, currently going around, and it seems like we're picking up pieces of a picture. I guess when you assemble the picture, it tells you a bit more about what the story is about. As you can see, you've got like a basic puzzle to start off with. Very simple little puzzle. And now we see some more writing, which tells you further information about the story. Okay, we got some instructions on the controls for the game. Another piece of the picture. Giant caterpillar. Crystals. Another piece of the picture. It's a path going up this way. Let's have a look around.
then a miracle happened. Oh, how I wish he could have seen her change. How her false smile became true. How his innocent light echoed through her until it ignited her very being. Used to bury his face in her neck and swirl her with joy. Her eyes would water and her heart would take flight.
Another collectible. so far it seems like they tell you the story as you progress through. You pick up collectibles that also give you more idea of what's happening in the story. Another part of the puzzle.
Her love didn't rest on any foundation. It became an endless ocean with no beginning or end.
I do believe with this game that you can skip a lot of the puzzles and you could just run through it and it only takes a few hours, but to fully appreciate the story I think that it's better to do all the puzzles. It also gives you a bit more information about the actual story if you do complete them. And if you are playing a puzzle game, you would want to, you know, you would want to do the puzzles.
Came grace, delight, and bliss, each amplified by truth.
so bright. Lots of caterpillars. Pictures starting to come together now.
Neither had known their purpose in life until they finally found the one thing they were willing to die for. David.
This is his parents, his father. I wonder if we ever find out why they all wear capes and have really weird coloured eyes. That bit I'm not understanding at the moment.
Although they never had much, they felt rich beyond measure during those early years. Blessed, she would say, and often did.
I guess you use this character to help you solve the puzzles.
Indeed, they truly were blessed. Where and when did they go wrong? How did they anger whatever deity that once had blessed them?
Looks like we have another puzzle.
Signs were there, but it was so much easier to focus on the smiles instead of the eyes. Falling prey to the same deception she had once perpetrated. And all the pieces are together. So obviously there's something wrong with this and thank you.
Here we go, another puzzle. Well, there we go, it's together properly now. I was wrong before. We were missing a piece.
Soon, the signs became more numerous than the smiles. Her anxiousness became worry. Worry became fear, and fear became the wind that extinguished her flame of all too brief joy.
The hooded figure looks like it's weeping. That figure is either the father or the mother. It's gotta be.
Sylvia became a vessel of sadness, a priestess of grief. It became a prison through which sorrow could be admired for its melancholic beauty.
I say it's weeping, but maybe it's just the pattern on its face.
Sylvia became a vessel of sadness, a priestess of grief. She became a prism through which sorrow could be admired for its melancholic beauty. It is said that in the darkest skies, we see the brightest stars. Hope, however faint, is hard to deny, whatever shape or name it may take.
So we started off in a cave and now we're out in the forest. So it seems like we're on the second level. So on each level, I think you have collectibles that you find throughout that certain level. Another puzzle as well.
False hope is better than none, she said as they argued, spending what little they had left, bargaining for a miracle cure. A fruitless search for a natural remedy, attested to by everyone save science.
So I'm not really sure who the figure is following the boy. Maybe it's just some random... It's just like someone who helps you do through the game doing the puzzles. So what I like about the game so far, the environment's really, really nice, and it definitely deserves the title of being a puzzle game, as you can see there are plenty of puzzles to do throughout the game. And obviously this is a game like no other, because it has a very emotional kind of story to it when you follow from start to finish. And it's odd for a game to have, you know, an emotional link to it. Very strange. Lots of colourful bugs throughout the game as well. The visuals are nice, but it appears that the game has some problem with frame rate. And obviously your character does walk quite slow. That's the only real thing I can see wrong with the game. And maybe certain people won't like it because it is purely just a story and puzzle driven game. There's no other, you know, there's no other aspects of the game, there's no combat, there's nothing like that in this game at all. It is literally solving puzzles to help you find out what happens.
It was a human thing, driven by a selfish desire to keep him among them at whatever the cost. But as often is the nature of mere hope, it is seldom enough.
Oh, excuse me.
The fainter the star of hope could shine, the harder she crumbled. She blanketed the rest of the world in darkness so that her star of hope could remain clear.
Another puzzle.
Together, they ran down every avenue of holistic
medicine. So as you can see so far, whenever you do a puzzle, you get a little paragraph underneath explaining more of the story. Whereas if you decide you're going to skip the puzzles, I don't think these will come up. So you'll miss out on a whole lot of the story if you don't do the puzzles. As I said before, they are optional. You don't have to do them, but it'd be pointless not to, because you wouldn't know what was happening properly in the game if you didn't do them. A lot of these puzzles you will find are very straightforward. This definitely seems like a game that anyone can play. It's not too hard or anything like that. It's definitely a thing that casual gamers could get into. So. So I take it that's what the developers want. They want you to think about who that other character is. I haven't got a clue. I assumed it was the boy's mother or father, but... I really don't know.
Many elaborate and well-traveled ways of self-deception have been invented to serve our desperate call for comforting illusions.
Yeah, apologies to you guys for skipping a lot of the text in the game. It's just that I have a time limit on my YouTube currently, and I'm trying to squeeze the whole game in to one video here, so you guys could see the whole thing in one go. Kind of spoils it a bit because you can't really see exactly everything that's going on.
Maybe there is a limit, a thin line that water cannot cross. Water cannot absorb salt forever, even if your grieving can make it seem so.
Nearly got all the collectibles for this level, it seems. Just a few pieces missing. So far I'm counting that we've done around 18 puzzles. So that's quite a lot of puzzles. Some other random creatures. Hope you guys are liking what you see so far. That there looks like the mother. And then the father in the doorway. Obviously you can see she's upset about everything that's happening. Looks like you're in some sort of cemetery.
As they got his definite diagnosis, eyes filled with tears, speaking the words that neither the mouth could say nor the heart could bear. It wasn't long after that the once beautiful hypocrite ceased to be.
What's going on? Is it just loading? I hope it hasn't crashed. No, it's loading. I'm sure it'll be fine. So who is this mysterious person that is following you around? And that's the end of what looks like the second chapter.
Wrapped in a blanket of depression and loneliness. Nero's words of concern.
It seems very, very short so far. Very short.
Unspoken or unheard.
So moving on from the forest.
She sat down and allowed the waves to wash over her.
We're in some kind of building now. Thank you. Definitely some issues with the frame rate. It's just frozen up. Takes a fair while to load.
Retreating from the world that had tricked her into love, only to take it from her. So this is it. In the end, grief is the price we pay for love, she said. The Bible, torn asunder on the floor. Her many words of prayer have gone unanswered, just like his words of affection. Her expensive medication, still unopened. Thank you.
So yeah, what I can gather so far is you're playing as this boy. Obviously, you were ill, and I take it you're like a spirit, and you're finding out what happened to you. You're literally going through, playing through these puzzles, and you're finding out what's happened. Still need to play through a bit more to try and find out who the other figure following you is, though. Still not 100%, and I wonder if we do find out.
And for a time, he shared the weight of her grief.
Whoever that person is following the boy is very irritating, though. Tends to get a lot in the way a lot when you're trying to solve puzzles. Bit of a weird puzzle.
Her lack of will to live did not mean she wanted to die. But a broken heart cannot mend if its most vital piece is missing. The slow bleedings of her soul could not be halted.
Heart with a piece missing. Puzzle games definitely seem like a very popular genre for Xbox One right now. They're releasing a lot of puzzle games. There was Numa. Don't know how many of you have played that. That was quite a good game. Very short, but a good game if you like puzzle games. There's another puzzle game that I'll be reviewing as well, Schrodinger's Cat. I'll be doing a gameplay and first impressions video for that as well, so hopefully you guys will check that out.
His footprints would forever wash away beneath the waves of sorrow that swelled and crashed from their looming loss.
This area, the game's definitely quite eerie feeling though.
canvas of her life had precious few colors upon it. It remained a dark and cloudy sight. Aside from that sole bright and wonderful star at its center. At her end, she knew death to be the only deity who truly could come when called upon. She would carry on in the hearts of those who remained.
So the collectibles for this level.
She left a note for David, wanting to let him know that she would be waiting for him. She wanted to tell him not to worry and to bring her one of his beautiful drawings.
He's counting down the months. Okay, we've just left that area. I believe that this is the last level of the game, so everything's gonna come out, gonna find out the last little bit of the story.
When Sylvia needed a rock to cling to, Nero watched her travel. When her night seemed eternal, he could not bring himself to become the candle she needed. He was at fault, no matter what others had said to comfort him.
Appears we're in some sort of sandy desert area. Few collectibles are in the first part of this level hidden. Ah, this puzzle looks familiar.
Nero had wandered far down the road of personal despair, too far into his own darkness to have seen her flame failing. Maybe he could have done more, or had he chosen to let her go? His first cycle of suffering was about to end. Their time together would soon be over, and he'd be forced to stand alone. Alone in the perpetual dark. From the place beyond, she wished Nero could see the world the way David did. She wished Nero could see himself the way David saw him. Now, David was the only light he had left. He came to accept the inevitable, and he would continue for as long as David's light would guide him. After that, he'd join him too. To walk alone, having the two stars of his life as mere memories of a past journey. No, he would never be able to travel down that future path of solitude. But the young David could sense his father's intentions. Death is not the end, he said. Keep us in your heart, and we shall never be lost. David smiled with such childlike sincerity that all the worn sorrow and heartache faded away, as if carried away by a gentle spring breeze.
Looks like all these drawings.
Become a light unto yourself.
Damn it. Kate the bloody way.
Thank you.
And there we have it, folks. That's Nero. Pretty emotional game.
The most beautiful hypocrite, and now the most radiant sun. Okay, I will make you proud, Nero said. I will endure for you, Hope.
Thanks for watching, guys. Check out my other gameplay and first impressions videos. Thanks for watching.
The other.